Today I'm going to introduce you to the Computer Management Console found in Windows. It's a great way of finding out information of what's going on your computer, what's going wrong, what's going right, what services are starting, what services are stopped. So since I'm using Windows 7, I'm going to open up my control panel. Now I go down here, click on the control panel, and open up control panel. Now, in Vista and Windows 7, it comes up grouped by category. I don't exactly like that. I usually have it grouped by large icons. So go over here and click onto large or small icons. And what we're after in here is administrative tools. So go over and click on administrative tools. That opens up. And over on the right here, you're going to see computer management. Go ahead and double click on computer management. That opens up the computer management console. Pretty simple. Now, there's a lot of stuff in here. It's possible to screw up settings in here and actually make more problems for yourself than you intended. So I wouldn't change too many things around in here if I was you, but it's definitely a good way to find out information. The best way to find out what's going on your computer is to use the Event Viewer right here, Event Viewer. So if you click on the Event Viewer, it quickly scans your computer and loads up all the log files and displays them for you. Click on the little chevron beside it and you see Custom Views, Windows Logs, Application and Service Logs, and Subscriptions. Well, the two that are the most interesting are Custom Views and Windows Logs. We're going to start in Windows Logs. If you click the little arrow or chevron beside Windows Logs, you're going to see Application, Security, Setup, System, and Forwarded Events. Setup and forwarded events are pretty boring, but the other three actually do give you some information. Now, inside application, this is where you want to be. Oh, look, I have an error. Something new, perfnet. Okay, not a problem. That's not a major issue. If you see a lot of red errors that repeat over and over again, and they're the same error, that can indicate that you have a problem on your computer. The best way to find out information about it, if you want to, is to copy down the error, go to Google, and Google that particular error. A lot of times, there's people out there that are having the exact same problem as you, and they'll be able to give you a solution to the problem. Other than that, you're going to see basic things like information. Information is nothing to worry about at all. It just tells you something started, yes, or something stopped, yes, and it was successfully loaded, or it was not successfully loaded. Well, actually, information won't tell you that. A warning will tell you if something is unsuccessfully loaded. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through the level. I'm going to change these around by clicking level up here. And I have several errors all over different dates, and the dates are spanned out quite a bit. Side by side was giving me an error until a while ago. And as you can scroll down and see warnings, the warnings usually aren't anything, you know, to be too concerned about. The ones that you are concerned about are the errors. And like I said, if you keep getting repeat errors over and over and over again, like if they go on for pages and pages, that means that you probably have a problem somewhere on your computer with an application. Usually it's not too much to worry about, but it could mean that slowing your computer down, there's a problem. So, like I said, if you have any problems about it, copy down the particular error. It shows it right down here. You can actually highlight the entire thing like that by holding down your mouse button and just highlighting all of it and press Control C on your keyboard. And here I'll show you. Notepad opens up. I could paste that into Notepad by pressing Control V. Now, if that was Google, here, I'll just show you in Google. Why not? I've got Google right up here, so I'll just Control V and search. Oh, look at this. Network performance counter availability. Here we go. There's all these different things I could go through. Usually it's best to go to the Microsoft site about them, and as it shows right here, it shows up as the official TechNetMicrosoft.com site. So if I was so interested in that error, I could go there, find out why it's happening, and probably find a solution to the problem. Anyways, that's enough of how to actually Google the problems that you're going to find in here. Now, you can't really break anything in here. These are just log reports, and that's about it. Where you could screw things up is down here in services and applications, but yet is still an extremely handy part of the console. So go ahead and click on the little triangle chevron there and click onto services. Now, these are all the services that start on your computer. They're installed by programs or by Windows itself. The best way to view these is by startup type, at least that's what I find. Now, a lot of these are set to manual and automatic. It's all arranged alphabetically. So I'm going to click on to startup type, and then I will click on to status. Well, here we go. Started, started, started. Okay, well, I want everything that started, so I'm going to click status a couple of times just to get everything that started right there. So those are all the ones that I have started. Those are the most interesting ones because, well, they're running right now. That means they're taking up memory on the computer. And if I want to know what they are, I can actually extend this. I wait till the little double-sided arrow comes up, hold down my mouse button, scroll that over, and I can see what they are. To get a basic description of what they are, just single-click on them, and you can read here on the left. Now, if you find something you definitely want to stop, what you could do is, say, the print spooler. If you didn't have a printer hooked up, there would be no point in really having the print spooler running. I don't endorse going in here and just changing things without knowing what you're doing or knowing 100% that you could disable it without affecting the performance of Windows or Windows booting up and loading. Like I said, you could screw things up in here if you mess around too much, but it's still very handy to know what is running on your computer. So, that aside, I'm going to double click on Print Spooler, and it shows me the Print Spooler Properties menu. In here, you're going to see a couple of interesting things. The startup type can be changed from automatic to manual, and I could also stop, which I am going to do. Print Spooler is now stopped. My printer will not work now, but I'm going to set that back to automatic, and I'm going to go ahead and start it. Simple as that. So, yeah, like I said, be careful in here. If you have any questions, either email me, just email contact@logixpc.com, or do like I did and just go Google it. Anyways, that's Computer Management Console. Don't be scared to explore it. It's very informative, very handy, and yeah, you'll learn a lot about your computer. Anyways, that's all, and thanks for visiting Logix PC.